Hey YouTube, Paul Phillips here with Hi-Tech Photography and Gear Reviews. Today I'm going to do a very quick review of the new Yongnuo YN-622N TTL triggers for Nikon. So finally, you know, much awaited, much talked about, much anticipated, I finally got one of them. I ordered one from the Yongnuo store and another two from the Photo Gadget, so I'm still waiting for the other two from the Photo Gadget to show up. But I'm hoping for great things from these triggers for sure. I'm used to the 603s, and I can tell you from my first impression is the build quality on the 622Ns is better than the 603s, so that's a good thing right off of the bat. As far as delivery, you know, packing, shipping, all that kind of stuff, I mean, came in a small box like so. You can order one or two of these from the Yongnuo store, the Photo Gadget, your choice. They come packed in a nice bubble wrap. They have the silica pellets to absorb the moisture. The look and appearance of them and the, I guess, the ergonomics, I would say, are really good. I mean, when you pop these onto your camera like so, they're not obtrusive. You know, they don't get in the way of anything so far, so that's a really good thing. Now, on the back of the units, you've got a nice hot shoe here. There's even a little lock pin, and you just pop the back cover off, and they take two AA batteries. I got two Analoops in there. Put the cover back on, like so, and you're ready to go. So on your right, there's a power on button here. So it gives you a little indicator for your offline mode, and then green if you're in TTL mode, and I think it's orange if you're in the manual mode. Like I said, I'm fairly new with these myself, but you've got a group button on this side, and when you press the group button, it'll toggle through your three group selections over here. On this side, you have a channel button, and when you press it, it'll toggle through the different channels. There's seven channels in all that you can set. And the channel button and the test button to fire your strobe, to do a test on your strobe, the test button has a minus and the channel button has a plus sign. And so the big money question that Nikon users are interested to know about, and that is, you know, can we do ratios or vary the output of our remote units from the menu on the camera? And my first impressions are the answer is no, you can't. From what I can decipher from the instructions, it looks to me very much like you vary the power output on the remote units by using the plus and the minus buttons on this side here. And so it's a fairly simple sequence of pressing your shutter button release halfway. The unit goes into transmitter mode, and then you push up or down to raise or lower the power. Like I said, I only have one of these, so I haven't been able to test them yet, but that's what I've been able to determine so far. The units also have a PC sync port on them, so if you're going to fire a strobe, you'll have that, like an Alien B or something like that, you'll have that capability. First impressions, I'm quite happy with them from what I see so far. There's an AF assist illuminator on the front here, and the nice thing about that is that it will work in conjunction with your AF assist illuminator on your speed light. So either or, which is a good thing. Haven't tested it yet. Also has a pass-through, so there's a hot shoe here, so you can have this on your camera. Speed light on top, and then there's two or three different modes of operation. There's a remote mode, a commander mode, like that, which is all covered in the instructions. I guess the weak area that I've seen so far is just the instruction manual. I mean, you know, kudos to Yongnuo. Whoever wrote the instructions, very clear they understand what they're talking about, but the translation to English is, I could almost see Yongnuo losing a couple of sales because people will get frustrated with these instructions. But if you can take your time and muddle through it, you should be able to figure it out. So that's it for this one. Just a very quick, you know, thumbs up. I mean, my initial perception on these units is that they should be quite good. We'll test them out in a couple of weeks when I get the other two units. And that's it for this one. Okay, we'll see you soon. Bye for now.